a theorem. What is the name of this theorem? Can you guess? Look at the picture. Look at the picture. Yes, it is known as sandwich theorem. What do you mean by sandwich? Sandwich is an item of food consisting of two pieces of bread with a filling between them. It is also known as squeeze principle. Squeeze means firmly press something between two other things. Now, what is the statement of this theorem? The statement of this theorem is, if AN, BN and CN are three sequences such that the first condition, AN is less than or equals to BN and BN is less than or equal to CN for all N belong to N. The second condition is, limit of AN as N tends to infinity is L, that is also equals to limit of CN as N tends to infinity. Then the limit of BN as N tends to infinity is L. That means if AN, BN, CN are three sequences such that there's an order, increasing order, AN is less than or equal to BN, less than or equal to CN, and the sequence AN converges to L and the sequence BN converges to L, then the middle one, the middle sequence BN is also converges to the same limit L. Now we recall what is the definition of convergent. The definition of convergent sequences, if you say limit of AN as N tends to infinity is L, that is the sequence AN converges to L, for a given epsilon greater than 0, there exists a natural number M such that modulus of AN minus L is less than epsilon for all N is greater than or equals to M. That is, if you remove this modulus, then we get L minus epsilon strictly less than AN, strictly less than L plus epsilon for all N is greater than or equals to M. Now we will prove this theorem. As we discuss the statement, the three sequences are in the increasing order and the sequence AN and CN converge to L, that the sequence BN is also unto L. What's the proof? Since we are given limit of AN is L, limit of CN is also L, that is sequence AN converges to L, the sequence BN also converges to the same number L, then by definition of convergent sequence, for a given epsilon greater than 0, there exist two natural numbers M1 and M2 belong to N such that modulus of AN minus L is less than epsilon for all N is greater than or equals to M1 and modulus of CN minus L less than epsilon for all N is greater than or equals to M2. We have chosen two natural numbers M1 and M2. Because M1 is for the sequence AN, M2 is for the another sequence CN. From 1 and 2, when you remove this modulus, as we seen in the previous slide, or by the definition of convergence of a sequence, we can write L minus epsilon is less than AN, less than L plus epsilon for all N is greater than or equals to M1, and 2 can be written as L minus epsilon is less than CN, less than L plus epsilon for all N is greater than or equals to M2. We call the set of these inequalities as 3. Now we are going to prove that the limit of the sequence BN, the limit of BN as N tends to infinity is L. For this, we have the same epsilon, but we have to choose a natural number M. that natural number, we take it as m equals to maximum of m1 and m2, which have been already selected or chosen for sequence A1, AN and sequence CN. We always choose the maximum for convergence so that this M, chosen M, satisfy both conditions. What is given? Hypothesis 2. The hypothesis 1 is given as AN less than or equal to BN less than or equal to CN. That is, call it as inequality number 4. Now from 3 and 4, we are going to get the answer. 3 and 4 says, this is 3, this is 4. Now from 3 and 4, we can write, look at this, L minus epsilon is less than AN. But what is AN? AN is less than or equal to BN, less than or equal to CN. What is CN? CN is less than L plus epsilon. Hence, we can write L minus epsilon less than AN, less than or equals to BN, less than or equal to CN, but CN is less than L plus epsilon. So, this inequality can be obtained from the inequalities 3 and 4. That is, L minus epsilon less than BN, less than L plus epsilon, because we are interested in the sequence BN. What does it mean? This is the reverse of convergent sequence. Whenever we have BN minus L less than epsilon, we can write like this. Similarly, whenever we have this inequality, this can be written as modulus of BN minus L less than epsilon for all N greater equal to M. That means the BN converges to L. That is, the limit of BN as N tends to infinity is also convergent and converges to the same limit L. Now, this is the graphical representation of the Swiss principle. Here, look at this. The sequence AN converges to L. Sequence CN converges to L, therefore BN is between AN and CN, also converges to L. That is, the sequence BN is squeezed between the sequences AN and CN. This completes the proof. Now we will do a problem. Show that limit of 1 by n square plus 1 by n plus 1 whole square plus 1 by n plus 2 whole square, so on, 1 by n plus n whole square as n tends to infinity is 0. Let us take the middle one, that is 1 by n square plus 1 by n plus 1 whole square, so on, 1 by n plus n whole square as bn. Now what do you have to prove? We have to prove limit of n tends to infinity, this is being bn, that is equal to 0. So that's the one we have to prove. Limit of this bn as n tends to infinity is 0. To prove this, look at these numbers, 1 by n square, 1 by n plus 1 whole square, 1 by n plus 2 whole square, so on, 1 by n plus n whole square. Which is the smallest one? Which is the greatest one? Since n is a natural number, from here 1 by n squared is the greatest, and the last term 1 by n plus n whole squared is the least. Therefore, we can have n plus 1 by n plus n whole squared less than bn less than n plus 1 whole squared for all n belong to n. This explanation of this is given in the next slide. Bn contains n plus 1 terms. Now clearly, 1 by n plus n whole squared is less than 1 by n squared. That is equal to 1 by n squared. And 1 by n plus 1 whole squared is less than 1 by n plus 1 whole squared. But this is less than 1 by n squared. Similarly, the third term, 1 by n plus 1 n whole squared less than 1 by n plus 2 whole squared less than 1 by n plus 1 by n squared. So on, 1 by n plus n whole squared is equal to 1 by n plus n whole squared is the last term of the sequence bn. This is the first term, which is less than 1 by n squared. Now we are going to add all. If you're adding all the above, what do you get? The middle one is 1 by n squared plus 1 by n plus 1 whole squared plus 1 by n plus 2 whole squared, so on, 1 by n plus n whole squared. That's the one middle one. How many terms are here? Look at this. How many terms are here? See, leaving the first term, we start with this. 1, 2, 3, n terms are there. So there are n terms here plus one term here. So there are n plus 1 terms. And look at the first one. These are all same number. What's the number? 1 by n plus n whole squared. How many such numbers are there? We have n plus 1 such numbers. Therefore, this can be written as n plus 1 by n plus n whole squared. Similarly, here there are 1 by n squared. How many 1 by n squared? Similar, there are n plus 1, 1 by n whole squared terms. Therefore, this can be written as n plus 1 by n squared. So, the middle one is clearly bn. Therefore, n plus 1 by n plus n whole squared is less than bn, less than n plus 1 by n squared for all n belong to n. Now, our aim is to show that limit of bn equal to 0. So, we consider the value, namely n plus 1 by n plus n whole squared as an and n plus 1 by n squared as cn. Therefore, it is from the previous slide clear that this is an, this taken as bn, this becomes cn, and hence we can have this an less than bn less than cn for all n belong to n. This satisfies the condition number 1. Now our aim is to show that limit of bn as n tends to infinity is 0. For this we are going to use sandwich theorem. Suppose we want to show that limit of bn equal to 0, using sandwich theorem, if we show that an converges to 0 and cn also converges 0, and hence by this theorem we can say bn also converges to 0. So now our aim is to show that limit of an as n tends to infinity is 0 and the limit of cn as n tends to infinity is 0. Now let us consider limit of an as n tends to infinity. Limit of an is this. We have chosen an is n plus 1 by n plus n whole squared as n tends to infinity. That is equal to limit n plus 1, n plus n whole squared is 2n whole squared, that is 4n squared. Now separate into two terms, n by 4n squared plus 1 by 4n squared. Now n is there, here n squared is there, 1 times it can cancel. Therefore we can write this is limit of 1 by 4n plus 1 by 4n squared. Apply limit to both terms. If you apply limit to the first term plus limit to the second term, as we know that 1 by n tends to 0 as n tends to infinity. Therefore its value is 0. Similarly, its value is also 0. Therefore 0 plus 0 is 0. Hence limit of an as n tends to infinity is 0. Now we will show that limit of cn as n tends to infinity is also 0. What is cn? Cn is n plus 1 by n squared. Let us consider limit of cn. Limit of cn is n plus 1 by n squared as n tends to infinity. Separate into two terms, n by n squared plus 1 by n squared. Now here n by n squared, 1 n get cancelled. Therefore limit of 1 by n as n tends to infinity, 1 by n tends to 0. Similarly, 1 by n squared also tends to 0, 0. Thus, limit of an converges to 0. Limit of cn converges to 0. Hence, by sandwich theorem, limit of bn is also converges to 0.